Make her score. Make my score.
Go
Six.
ahead, make my score. Yeah. All right. Well, we can't continue. So, wow, this is real basic. Throwing down your ghetto hoodie.
It's my ghetto hoodie. We are preparing, you know, we're showing our best selves
We're gonna do
for the
this
day.
gangster style. Yeah. All right. Oh, weird. It's just like
Oh,
black.
no, but, oh, damn it, I think you need to restart. Or we, oh, no, it doesn't matter. You can, that's better, that's better. You
What?
could choose me to play, or they, you could either choose to create a new character,
Okay.
or you use one of the forum peeps, so with sprite, like me.
Do you actually select before this screen or after?
Before. But
Okay.
just go with, you know, you go with Gumby or Squish,
Well,
who are the
let me
best
try something really
nickname
quick.
ever. Try just not on the window if you clicked on anything else. I can't see what you're doing.
All right, hang on.
New game. New
All right, do you
character, of
see
course.
that? See, this didn't show before. So do I want a new character? Or do I want forum
Yeah,
stuff?
probably.
Okay.
Oh, I see. You don't know them except me.
Okay, so, wow, you can't actually type, you have to do this thing. All right, we'll do E, B. Wonder if it'll actually fit. That would be cool.
We must be with evil juju or bad juju. You do
It's
realize you
weird the way the
selected the J instead of L.
Oh, did I?
Yeah.
How do you go back? There's no back command.
Doesn't matter. Let's just continue with Eevee
English
being
King.
Gumby.
All
Yeah,
right, whatever.
that's such a good variation. You know, if it was me, I'd have chosen EKG because it's shorter. And I'm lazy.
Yeah, it technically doesn't matter. Though the kerning on the font's a little funky.
Oh, that I haven't seen. Like yourself. Oh, we don't.
I get to like choose my little butterfly, cute.
You totally have glasses, so there's only one option.
Yep, I'm the chode. Time to find the person of our dream. Sure? Nah. Sure.
Also, with an Australian accent, if you may. So, hey there, folks! This is your. I can't do accents, though. That's kind of rebuttal. Hey there, folks! This is your hostess with the mostest, Liberty! Welcome to another episode of Relationship Maintenance Network! RMN! The game you've always been waiting for! The game show where lucky contestants may or may not find true love! Today's lucky in love contestant is none other than RMN's very own Eevee
Evich King Gubby, yeah. And I
Gumby!
whistle, woohoo!
Let's start with any time, shall we? I'm sure our lucky lads and lasses around the corner are just as curious about our contestant as they are about them. Now, the rules of the game are simple. Pay people, give them money, win.
Bribe them well.
Now, the rules of the game are simple. You will get to choose three questions to ask your possible love interest beyond the wall. You can't see them, and to do that, you have these question mark heart thingies. They contain people. We sealed them safely away. They are still able to talk, but they are not able to move
They're
or do
stuffed
anything
inside.
for that matter. That is perfect.
And they're
It's
really
perfectly
small.
ethical. We had them sign a paper.
It's like a
You
companion cube.
will then have to pick the answer you feel best resonates with you. Pick wisely. Every answer you do gives you points. After three questions, the total will be tallied, and whoever gets the most points will be your lucky companion for all expenses paid date. Settle down, ladies and gents. The game hasn't even started yet. All right, all right. So, all set? Ready to meet your matches in love?
There we go. Now they got the music on. All right.
All righty then. Let's get this show on the road. Here are the first three questions. Pick one to ask.
Question one, our game's art. Discuss. Question two, what got you into making games? Question three, what is your favorite RTP sound effect and why? What the heck is RTP?
RTP is the runtime package. It's the like the basic assets you get provided with the RPG Maker. So it's like the basic tile set, these chibi sprites and all that, all in that runtime package.
We'll take question two because I have no idea.
Oh my, what a question! What do you think, Paramour 1? How will you answer that? Designing RPGs in a notebook after playing Dragon Warrior 4 for the 10th time. Well, no, that was quite an answer. What did you think, Evil King Gambi? Did you like that one? Perhaps Paramour 2 will have an answer more to your liking. Final Fantasy VII.
Because, you know.
You know, that got you into gaming and game design. My, oh my, that's a pretty interesting answer, too. How will you pick? Perhaps you won't have to. Will Paramus 3's answer make for an easy choice? My aunt has worked for a bunch of different publishing companies in Surrey, got a bunch of free gaming magazine subscriptions. GamePro, Electronic Gaming Monthly, Game Informer, which I devoured monthly. I never actually played the games as I grew up fairly poor. Since that, I was making my own video games in my head, on paper, even on the ground. Sticks and Titans. I made a ton of card games, board games, etc. as a kid. In middle school, I discovered RM2K and Don Miguel's Adventure, and everything just sort of spiraled into craziness from there. Amen. Interesting, what do you think, Yuji Kengambi? Which of these answers will you choose as your favorite of the bunch? Who will win your warm regards this round? Is that the first one, really?
Actually, I was going to take three, but I didn't realize the prompt was at the top.
Yeah, I would have taken three, too. So if you get one, you may want to even the points off and just pick three. Anyway. Congratulations, Paramour 1. You totally didn't deserve that one. But be happy with it, since you know just what our contestant likes to hear. But will you keep the lead or lose it to one of the other contestants? What are the next batch of questions for a lucky contestant to pick from? Here they are.
Are religious undertones in a game important to you? What is your favorite genre of game and why? Or do you believe in love at first sight? Oh, yeah. Oh, definitely number three.
Jeez, that's a pretty good question. Let me make a note of it for my... let's see the Paramour's answers.
One. Yes.
Yes. Quite an interesting answer. Not sure that's what I'd have said, but it's definitely decent. Now, Paramour 2, can you do better? Come on, then. No. That was us. And on that note, let's see if our third Paramour can beat that. My first game-related site was Gaming Re, so absolutely not.
Aww.
Well, that's a set of answers I wouldn't want to pick from. Good thing I'm not you, right, Evil Kim Gambi? How will you choose? Now that's a great choice. I thought you'd pick an answer, but you never know when it comes to contestants on this show. There's some weird people out there. Now, time to pick your next question for the evening. Are you ready? Here's your choices.
Question one. You've just been told RMN is going down indefinitely. What do you do? Question two. RIP, RTP, or custom? Discuss. Question three, what have you always wanted to implement and or create but haven't yet? We'll go with three.
Hey, now that's a great question. So, do you have what it takes to win our Eve King Gambit's heart, partner one? Let's hear your answers. And we can see if you take the full name, it goes over the box. We can totally report it as a bug.
Yeah.
A 2D side-scrolling Eve by old clone, but with dragons. Oh my god, dragons, that's good. Oh, see, that's the type of answer the audience wants to hear. Thoughtful yet interesting. But will it beat out the other two? Let's see, shall we? Paramore 2. A Manakemia JRPG-esque game that has the same immersion, if not more, as Time Moon plus Nitro's narrative.
Not bad.
What do you think? Is it enough to win your over Evil King Gambit? Don't answer that. Let's see the third answer first. A big sort of traditional JRPG akin to Dragon Quest 3 or 9. I'll probably never do it since all of my ideas tend to focus around short games. And there we have it, the third answer. Now, whose answer would choose as the best?
Now, one thing I'm curious about is why is the third answer yellow? It's like the first is blue, the second is pink.
And the third one just stands out with
Kind of the choice of color for the fonts I don't think is great, because it's honestly the difference between the very, very subtle first one and second one, it almost looks like the same.
Pink or red, that would have worked well.
What's that?
With pink or red, that wouldn't be the problem. Someone already complained about that on the side, actually. It feels like this choice is more important.
Exactly. It feels more weighted. Like, that's the golden answer.
Oh, no, that is a good pick. Congratulations, Farmer 3. You did really well, but I bet the next round will cause some issues if you rest on your laurels. Let's see, shall we? Question 1.
Are religious undertones in a game important to you? Gameplay, graphics, story, or sound? What do you prefer in a take? Our game's art. All right, we got to go for that second one. Gameplay, graphics.
That's a good question. Come on, you lot. I want to hear the answer to this. Room 1, you're to go, go, go! When it comes to dating, I'm going to be shallow and go with graphics.
And they also believe in love at first sight, so it makes sense.
That was a good answer, but is it enough to give you the lead against whatever the other two Paramus can come up with? Your turn, Paramu 2. Sound. I suggest playing the news by Zigzag on full volume, and you'll know why. you might have messed it up with that one. Oh well, you can't change your answer now. Hopefully it's not going to cause you to lose the game of love. Next answer. Gameplay is pretty important in games. Everything else should help solidify and enhance the gameplay. Wow, this is going to be hard to choose. You better think carefully about this, or you might regret your choice, Evich King Gambit.
Evich King Gambit.
So who do you think? Who
I'm definitely going with the 3 on that one. I completely agree.
Great job, Paramore 3. You really know how to hit the right notes of Evich King Gambit. Can you score the last question, though? Go ahead, Evish King Gambit. Choose.
Choose, but choose wisely. What is your idea of a wonderful game-make session? Question 2. What are the most powerful of game-wise? And 3. What do you look for in a husband or waifu game-make partner? Oh. All right, just because it's completely ridiculous, why not?
This is the last question of the night, so let's not waste any more time. I'm sure everyone is anxious to see the answers and find out who wins the game of love.
Ooh.
Your answer, if you please, Power Move 1. Someone who likes video games and hockey.
Okay.
Well, that really went over, beloved contestant. Let's see what Paramo 2 has in store to win their hearts instead, shall we? Good artists will rivet imagination but still remain on the logical side of things, especially if they are a woman.
I guess you have to use a keyboard.
Good answer, but is it enough? Palmer 3, yours is the final answer for the night. Make sure it counts.
I don't even know what that is.
Palmer.png.
Do you know what that is? I feel like I should look it up or something.
Not telling.
You're not telling? Alright, I'm totally looking it up. I'm searching for it. ERSU. God, a summon, not the ping. Images. I found a WordPress site for some chick dressed like a Santa's elf with a candy cane. Is that it? I'm not sure. Huh, some interesting artwork. Sure. Why not? Still with me? I lost you. I think you're muted. Hello? Hello? Why can't I hear you? What happened? Why can't you hear me? Hello? Hello?
Oh, of course.
There you are.
Damn it. That's what happens when you have, you know, a button on your mic. I don't know how I hit it, but apparently I did.
Oops.
The person of our castleman is also a different member of the side. And congratulations, Power War 3, but the game isn't over yet. Was this enough to net you the win? But as Evish King Gambi's heart belonged to another. Let's tally the points. Now we had a tangent all building up. And the winner is... Paramore 3! Come forward, Paramore 3, and reveal your identity to Evish King Gambi. And now come and introduce yourself to Evish King Gambi.
Somebody with a fro?
Oh my god, this is even a female. Oh no, it's Grave. Evish King Gambi, this is Grave. You have chosen them as your match. I hope you both find love, or at least don't kill each other or something. Wait, was that a guy or girl? I don't even know. If they listen to this, they'll hate me. But that's perfectly okay. Unfortunately, that's all we have time for tonight, ladies and gents. Let's end the show with a big round of applause for all our players in this, the Game of Love. Until next time, folks, keep your hearts on your sleeves and take care. This is Liberty, signing out. And you still see Michael.
All right.
I'd
Looks
say
like a
in
girl.
Terms of...
the little Playboy Bunny outfit.
This ride definitely is. I'm not sure if... I really don't know. It's kind of... I thought he was a guy, and he was always referred to by him.
Well, me and Craze are a 47% match. Which is not really that good.
So far to mediocre. That's...
All right, let's try this again. So is the contestants that end up on the chopping block random?
Yeah.
Okay.
I didn't have Grace before. I did have Liberty. I did have Liberty, the host.
We'll just do EKG.
And I'll just skip the narration because they are the
of course not. What the heck? I'll make myself blue haired.
Oh.
Yo, dis okay with you?
Oh god.
Yeah, sure.
You still took him. That's very brave of him.
Oh wow, now it's Slender Man as host?
Oh yeah, and you read it out.
Slender Man doesn't actually talk. That's really strange. Hello,
it's
one and
Slender
all.
Man, it's a Do you see, you know, he has a tie.
Yes, he's very formal. Hello, one and all. Welcome to my game. I will be your host this night. Welcome to an episode of Relationship Maintenance Network. So lovely. Ooh. La, la, la. Will you find love, or will you end up on the pain, up in the pain of despair? Weird. Today's unlucky contestant is none other than RN's very own EKG. So many three letters. Time is fleeting, and I have teens to terrorize, so let us get down to business. Don't look at me! The rules are simple. You will choose which question to ask your paramours, and they will answer. Pick the answer you like best. Each answer will give a point towards that person. Whoever has the most points at the end of the game will win! Blah, 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 blah. Are you ready? Then let's start. Here are the first three questions. Pick one to ask. What do you look for in a husband or waifu game make partner? Do you indulge in game make abuse of any kind? If so, detail. What is your favorite RTP sound effect and why?
The third one is the most important.
Say what?
The third one. I think for my answer, I just thought I didn't know, but hearing the answer today is so obvious. Oh,
That's
you're not going
question.
For the sound effect.
What do you think, Paramore One? Oh, heck no.
I'm disappointed in you.
I don't know the sound effects, so it doesn't really matter. If I ask that question, I'm not going to know what any answer means.
I could show you. You do have the runtime package, so you could just look it up and be like, oh my god, the jump is the best. Or the chest sound. Oh, the chest sound is lovely too. But the jump is so silly. Anyway. No, I don't think so. Just like youngsters traveling through fantastic worlds.
Well, I guess that's an answer. And how about you, Paramore 2? Will you answer sway the heart of our contestant?
Yeah, mark neglect, mostly.
Huh. Did your answer cause a stir in your heart, EKG? Well, let's see what Paramore 3 has to say.
I don't even know why I asked this question, but okay, sure, I indulge in it, I guess. Maybe? I don't even...
Very confused.
Is that a sign that this is liberty?
And there you have it. Three answers for your question, EKG. Now it's up to you to pick the answer that most intrigued you. Take your time. I don't even know. I'll say two. Congratulations, Paramore 2. You have managed to interest our contestant, but will you manage to keep their interest? Let's see, shall we? Time for the next round. Here's the next batch of questions for you, EKG. Question one, what is your idea of a wonderful game make session? Question number two, gameplay, graphics, sound, or story or sound? I'm reversing this in my head. What do you prefer on a date? Question three, you've just been told RMN is going down indefinitely. What do you do? I'm going to do three. Ho-ho! That's an interesting question. How will you answer it? Mm-hmm.
I always wanted to play in band. So I would start my surf rock dream.
That certainly works. What do you think, EKG? Does it tickle your fancy? Either way, let's see what Paramore 2 has to offer.
Get Red Nova's contact info because we still need to do stuff for a game. Also, console Unity.
Well, it was certainly an answer. Question is, was it good enough to win the heart of our contestant? Or perhaps the next question will instead.
Yeah, not Red Nova or Unity. And everyone loves Unity, you see.
Yes.
Because she's such a friendly lady. And that's why everyone loves her. She's very shy, and that makes people compliment her all the more, because, you know, they just feel safe doing it. And she gets all flustered.
You go,
so anyway, oh god, panic some more. Take a deep breath, then try to work out a way to keep the site afloat.
Loyalty to the site. And that was the last answer to the second of tonight's questions. What do you think, EKG? What is your favorite? I actually like three. I see. Good job, Paramore 3. You win a piece of EKG's heart. Let's see how much you do for the next round, though.
That's
Here are the choices. Question one, 2K/3 or XP? Explain. I don't even know what that is. Question two,
That's
RIPs, RTPs.
The RPG Maker engines.
Oh, What is your favorite genre of game or why? All right, we'll go question one. This question, can you answer it in a way that makes EKG hot for you?
2K3 because it has lower resolution. And I'm bored with just full mouth of full HD in 2K.
Good answer, but will it be enough? What's your take on the question, Paramount 2?
So turn you off, I'm sure. Well, I own XP, so that.
I have it, so I'll pick it. Not the answer I'd pick, but for sure. But that's for sure, but it might be enough. Unless, do you have a better answer?
2K3 all the way. Sorry, but the only good thing about XP is the mapping capabilities. And even that has some issues, though they're very minor. And some of the anime battlers, I guess so much of songs are okay too. Otherwise, blah. 2K3 all day, every day, baby.
Ah, well, that
every
really...
It
will be enough to win you a heart, EKG. What is your choice? I think the three actually had the rational explanation, so I'll go with that. Good choice. Good for you, Paramore 3. You certainly won that round. But will you do as well in the next? Bring the next batch of questions.
Yes.
Question one. What is the prettiest game you ever played, and why am I prettier? Question two. What have you contributed to our society? Question three, what is the last game you've made, played, and did you enjoy it? Totally got it, three. Well, that's one less question to ask. Let's get this going, shall we?
Pizza's game. I'm not sure if it's right, the answer to write that I enjoyed them. They were too deep and short Sith for that.
Short Sith? Is that like short for short-sighted? I don't... Well, don't get it. Well, it certainly does it for me. How about you, EKG? Oh, but there are two more answers yet to come.
Pizza's also a good artist, and he does short artsy games with a lot of open-ended stuff. So mixed bag. They're pretty. Cool. Harvest Moon, Friends of Mineral Town. It lets me carry a puppy around, so basically 10 out of 10. Game of the year!
Puppies! You almost scare me with how much that answer makes me want to cry. Paramore 3, you certainly can do better than that, right?
Played some Skyrim. Yes, I did enjoy it, though I got a bad random roll with my character.
Great. Well made. Well, make your choice, EKG. I'm thinking Skyrim, even though what they're saying makes absolutely no sense. There are no random rolls, but whatever. Brilliant! Congratulations, Paramore 3. You managed to win this round, but will you win the last one? Come along, let's move to the last round. Pick a question.
Three is so proud.
Rips RTP or custom, discuss. What are you most proud of game-wise? What have you contributed to our society? I'll do society. This is the final question of the night. Huh, I'd have picked something else myself, but I guess that's what you want to ask. Go ahead and ask, Paramore 1.
Nothing at all. A few words of broken English, but I plan to.
A very crappy answer. We'll move on.
Long, rambling opinions on gay narrative. Also, eggplants.
Is that really enough to win the heart of our dear contestant? Or is there a better answer waiting in the wings?
Or a bit, I guess. Some resources, reviews, games, a lot of posts. So many posts. I should stop posting.
Will that last question of the night be enough to set aflame the heart of the contestant, or will it backfire spectacularly on our third paramour? Let's see, shall we? Who wins this final round? I'm going to say three.
Brings a lot to the table. That's a good thing.
Wonderful. You did very well, Paramour 3. Now we just need to tally the votes for each round and find out the overall winner. Who will it be? And the winner is Paramore 3 again. It's almost like this is like rigged. Come forward, Paramore 3, and show your butt cheeks. I've been introduced.
Oh, I know who it is. It is.
It's Liberty. You've chosen them as your match. I hope you both find love, or at least don't kill each other or something. I'm confused, and she's whistling. Unfortunately, that's all the time we have for today, ladies and gents. Let's end the show with a big round of applause for all our players in this, the Game of Love. Until next time, folks, keep your hearts on your sleeves and don't talk to strangers. Wear clean underwear.
Candy, 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 yummy.
Eat lots of candy.
Sweetie, sweetie, girl's love. Okay.
Well, there you go. This time it was Liberty, and we're sitting talking over a plate of...
yeah,
it looks like an ice cream cone with a baseball helmet on it. I'm not even sure. 69% match. Ooh, baby.
And now, having read all the stuff, you can just give it any go for the answers. I still want to see if I can get newbie. Yeah, I totally want to get newbie. I'd be really curious what they write. And you don't know any of these names, so that makes it even better. But I can explain some of the stuff. Biru. Biani.
Yeah. Okay. Fire nuts. Yeah.
Pick yourself or die.
No, it's kind of... Why is there only one female?
Hey, let's go for a date, eh? Yeah, sure. Yeah. It looks like a Canadian's going to be called beer nuts. Okay.
Head of all looks, this is your hostess with the most celebrity.
So that was last time. Welcome to another episode of blah, blah, blah. All right, we'll blow through it then.
Yeah, let's blow.
I will not make you ask every question. I'll just skim. Beer nuts!
Yeah. Yes!
Let's not waste any time. Rules of the game are simple. Blah, blah, blah. You will have blah, blah, blah. Three questions. Blah, blah, blah. Settle down. Shut up. Alrighty. Question one, what are you most proud of games-wise? Question two, what is the last game you made, played, and did you enjoy it? Question three, what do you look for in a husband-wife owner? I'll do question one. What do you think, Paramount One? How will you answer that?
Figuring out the core of what makes a game fun or interesting and making sure everything else in the game helps that core. As of this moment... I'm going to have to say the functionality of the random blasting in Akitu Star Apprentice. It took at least two frustrating, hair-tearing days to figure it all out, but I totally pulled it off in the end. And that's a kind of magical girl game that's very popular, that a guy in question often uses the character portraits to enhance his speech and the character style, so it's like commenting off. My God, you should have totally done that with, you know, angry face.
Okay.
It is, not sure, between running gag and then just fun stuff. Original scripting for the win!
it's organal. They typed it wrong. Organal!
It was original.
No, it was O-R-G, not O-R-I-G-I.
Oh, I thought I saw an I in there.
Nope.
The characters I've come up with and the situations I have them in.
What do you think, Beer Nuts? I'm going to go with one.
Yeah, I can. I agree. Good taste. Good taste.
Here they are. Do you indulge in game make abuse of any kind? If so, detail. Gameplay, graphics, story, or sound, what do you prefer? And what is the prettiest game you ever played and why? I'll go with two. How superficial are you? Let's see the Paramore's answers!
I'd be lying if I didn't say I noticed graphics first, but past that, story and gameplay are the qualities that make for an unforgettable experience. For me, story, I'd want us to really get to know each other, learn about each other's likes and dislikes, see how well we hit it off. If I can be greedy, I would choose two, graphics and story. Even a well-thought-of story can suffer from poorly used or made graphics, and the same can be said about a well-crafted graphics can be used on a poor story.
I'm going to go with two.
Here's your choices.
2K3 or XP? Do you indulge in game-make abuse? Or what is your favorite genre and why? I will go with genre.
Yes. A tough one. I love the fierce challenge of a good action game, but nothing can equal the beautiful experience of an RPG world can build. Still, any game I can play with my friends is almost always the best.
Social gamer.
Oh, so that's the answer. It's probably faster to say what kinds of genres I don't like, which boils down to puzzlers than horror.
Kind of aversive. I don't really like that.
RPG games, because they mainly focus around the story aspect rather than gameplay like, say, a shooter game or a puzzle game. And there we have it.
We'll go with one. I like one better. What have you
Society.
What are your thoughts on the three tile rule? What have you always wanted
three
to do?
Three tile rule refers to a rule in the map creation. So if you're mapping and this is my shameful secret. I've never finished an RPG. I want to make a beautiful RPG with lovable, hateable characters that feel human. One day.
That was a good answer, but no.
There's this one game idea that I keep shelving that involves a sci-fi setting with mechs and tactical battles. Funnily enough, I was looking into the tactical battles part before the McBacon jam hit. That's a collaboration event. And the idea was shelved yet again. Also, that's also McBacon. Is the Sir Bacon night I mentioned.
Oh, okay.
Sometimes that's... They also organized a kind of event just for people to get together and then create games under a theme.
Fun.
My own games. Cool. So, okay, seriously, I always wanted to create my own RMVXA three-man party menu and have it look the way I want. But it is proving rather difficult. With limited scripting knowledge. Help?
One. What are your thoughts on the three-tile rule? What corner of the internet would you take me on an internet date and why? What is the last game you made, played, and did you enjoy it? I like the second one.
Yes. So
the last question. Your answer, one.
We are falling in the fields of Twitter and go people-watching before hanging out on Steam and playing games together.
I don't Twitter. Ugh.
If you have a Steam account, I would suggest friending each other and talk that way. Maybe even play a game together. That's a bit less certain. Otherwise, I'd set up a quick topic and talk that way. It's not as instant a conversation as in a chat room, but it's more private. The anime and manga side of the internet, because I want to know if the person I'm dating has similar tastes as I do. I watch a lot of anime and read a lot of manga and... Amongst all the bad, there are good anime and manga out there. Under the pile of shit, there are gold nuggets.
Yes, there are.
And beans.
All right, well, that was kind of a split all over the place, so I'm not sure who the winner would be. Paramore won! Yeah, I did kind of pick that more often. Romantic date for free tomorrow night. Now come and introduce yourself, Beer Nuts. Beer Nuts says, baby.
Oh my god, it's Slash.
Slash.
Slash has done a lot of more action, more gameplay orientated games. There was one action top down game where you wore the particles and could. And it was Mirror Boy where you could reflect them. There was one platformer that with some puzzle elements that was really popular, but I haven't played that one.
83% match.
He does good stuff. I really like his stuff.
Alright, give it one more try.
Yes. Can you get me? That is the question. Can you get me? And in Saramina, I've gotten Liberty and Slash before, and I want to see some new people. Please. Or am I answered? I have no idea what I actually answered. I can't remember.
Since it's random, it's hard to tell if you're actually there. Sure.
Yeah, well, you can only tell by the answers that at some point you can tell if you know them, or you may guess. Relationship Maintenance Network.
It's the same host. So what is it, like two hosts?
Yeah. Tyler! Oh, Tyler, that's... Then we need one with me as the girl, so we have to use the girl's pride too. I demanded. We make up with Kale.
Alrighty then, come on.
Alrighty then.
Our games are... What is your favorite genre of game and why, and what are you most proud of game-wise? Alright, we'll go with the our games art, because we haven't done that yet.
But of course, anything that a human being puts their heart and mind and body into is art, whether it's a game or a really tasty sandwich.
This sandwich is hot. Now I want a sandwich for dinner. Alright.
What did you say?
2 didn't actually say anything. It just skipped past it.
Oh. Either that's a bug or someone really didn't like it. Everything is art. And games too. 1, come on. You know you want the sandwich.
Yeah, that one was actually funny. The point is good. Next batch of questions.
Oh, there's one question you never even see.
How often do you gimmick? What is your idea of a wonderful gimmick session? What corner of the internet would you take me? I'll do the first one. How often do you gimmick?
Every morning and nearly every night. And when I'm not gimmicking, I'm thinking about gimmicking.
This sounds like sex. I like.
Just thought of that sort of that, like, yeah, I like romance and action, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, it's like consistent too. It's just skipping past it every time.
Yeah, I guess it's like that's just a bug.
A bugger. Their answers didn't line up properly. Ever.
Every day.
Oh yeah, 1.
Oh yeah, 1. That's totally hot stuff.
But guys, you've been making games. What is your favorite RTP sound effect and why? What are your thoughts on the 3-tile rule?
Oh, come on, go with the sound effect, please.
Screechy.
The screechy demon sound would rip the pitch turn up either really high or really loud. It's just so fun and useful, I fall back to it a lot.
All right, Paramore 2. See? Nothing. And Paramore 3.
Applause 1. We should be clapping for me anyways.
There you have it. Hey, we're going with 1.
Yeah, 1 is too awesome. And 2nd is, you know, the cool
2K3 or X-Men.
Child and storyline.
Do you believe in love at first sight, or where do you come from? Where do you go? Where do you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? Oh, God. All right, Cotton Eye Joe.
And that's also one where a game-related favorite pickup line. To be honest, this song grates on my earballs a little bit. I'm from a world of snow, living in a garden of frozen roses. I don't know where I'm going to go, but I'm sure I'll enjoy it.
And nothing
for 2. You might have messed up that one. New Jersey, USA, RPGmaker.net, Kansas. Yeah, that's just...
Yeah, we just go with the first one.
Yeah. I'm not a huge fan. It's so wonderful to have the pickup lines. There's so awesome stuff.
Play graphic story or sound, what do you prefer? Do you indulge in game-make abuse? And what is your idea of a wonderful game-make session? We'll do 3. That's fun.
I wake up early, pour a hot cup of coffee, and dive into my work. If I can create even one small, beautiful thing, I can be happy.
The mention of
like
coffee.
Like cream.
The mention of coffee makes that win, unless somebody else mentions coffee. Paramore 2 will be silent, and Paramore 3...
Seeing things coming together.
Like, that's
come on, you're boring.
Not even
please.
Trying.
You know, the second one has the silent beauty.
No.
That's the one really, really nailed it.
And the winner is Paramore 1 by a landslide.
Oh, what a god. Come on. You know the percentage is like 1%. I managed to get that.
And it's Slash again.
We love Slash so much. Did the percentage rise? Please say it rose. It rose. Come on. Yeah, you can't fast forward. And you didn't even hear any pickup lines. That's such a shame.
89%.
Oh, yes, it went up. 89%.
Booyah.
You're such a good match.
All right, one more shot. Let's see if we can get...
Kale, come on. Jing, jigsaw. Jig, jig. Jiggy, jig. Jigglypuff?
Jiggly. Except I actually used a J, but whatever.
Jiggly. Okay, Jiggly.
We'll pick the blue guy again.
No love for the female's pride.
Jiggity, giggity, jiggity,
I'm horrified. Yes.
Relationship
we
penis
need,
network!
We need one episode with the first female's pride.
It's Jiggly!
You look like a king. Waiting for... I don't know. Alrighty then.
According to the internet, we take on an internet date. Our IP, RTPs are custom. Where do you come from? Where do you go? We'll go with the first one.
Well, we'll find an MMORPG that neither of us has played. A new world to discover together.
I like that answer.
I bring you to YouTube and show you awesome, funny, creepy videos.
That's actually
involving
good
cats. I hope they involve cats.
Involving cats? No, they must involve unicorns. And
oh, scrappy body. The naughty, sometimes scary fetish side of things, so that you can know my deep, dark secrets. A whole new world.
Whoa, we got a creeper.
That's a bad opening. That's a bad opener. The first one was the one with the MMORPG, the second one was YouTube, and the third one was a new
discover
world!
Discover together, be amused together, or be perverted together. Mr. Gray, no. Amusement, discovery. I like discovery. Next batch of questions. What is your favorite RTP sound effect? What do you look for in a husband or waifu? What is your idea of a wonderful game make session? We'll do husband or waifu.
Yes. Someone who will challenge every idea I have and who doesn't mind me challenging every idea they have. Someone who shares my vision but will endlessly debate how to get there. Let's help each other improve. That they're fun, laid back, but can keep my lazy ass in gear. And probably my lazy ass. Wowzers! Someone with a deep heart and sharp intellect who can bounce ideas off of each other to create games that don't fall neatly into the whole save the world, everything is awesome bit.
I definitely get the old anti in three. I like one, though. Do you believe in love at first sight? What is your idea of a wonderful game make session, or what is your favorite RTP sound effect? Sound effect!
Really, I hate them all so much. So much. But the chest sound effect, that's one I associate with good experiences. It's the sound of discovery and possibility. That one monster cry, I can't remember the name. Sounds like a kinda cute squeal. Like a tiny baby monster that's trying to be intimidating, but just makes it go, aww. I found myself gravitating towards the darkness. Because by slowing it down, it makes a perfect partner to any dialogue of the big, bad, evil guy.
Yeah, that's a good one. What is your favorite genre of game and why? What are your thoughts on the three-tile rule? Our game's art.
We haven't gone to pick up the question once.
Nope.
It's important to be able to explain why it's wrong. The hell's that?
It's like the three-tile rule. Nobody knows what the hell it is.
It's a rule in map making. I think it's that every three tiles you should have something different. Not true. A word uniformity doesn't solve any problems. What makes the individual special is their own touch in the world they create. Or having a uniform? I don't know. It's just
I would definitely say three on that one.
Yes. Jiggly.
What is the prettiest game you've ever played and why am I prettier? You've been armies going down and da da da. And we'll go with one. And that's the last question. Paramore one!
The prettiest game I've ever played was Child of Light. I didn't know I was capable of enjoying a game based purely on its beauty, but that game proved me wrong. As for you, you're kind of 16-bit, but keep working on it. Shadow of the Colossus. Well, more than just the graphics, I'd have to play you to tell. Ah, I could answer. That wasn't my own. I kid. I'd have to say Everlong, if only for the fact that it brought so many wildly different art styles together and created a world that still felt alive. No offense, sir or madam, but I haven't met you yet.
Oh, that's tough. I have never played Everlong, so I don't really know. And the first two... Child of Light is actually a really, really gorgeous game, and so is Shadow of the Colossus. Though, I think I'd like Shadow of the Colossus a little bit more.
Good choice. Good choice. I approve.
It's by Team Ico. It's a classic.
And the winner is the one
big surprise!
And who is it? Is it Slash again?
Some rare guy.
This is Locus. You have chosen them as your match. That, I hope you... Oh, that's a guy. He does a lot of... He has a tweet where he designs boss battles for other people because he really enjoys that. he's part of the dev team for TextMod. And he's kind of cynical about many things.
Wait, he's part of the dev team for what?
The text kind of adventure game. You're just the, you know, just.
Oh, I gotcha. 70% match. Yeah, not really.
Oh, yeah. He's too cynical for you. Right, and with the female's front. And we will get these pickup lines. And will your horse score this hearty? Did you find love? Can you see this?
Go, go, go!
Go, go, go!
Blah, 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 blah.
Hottie!
You could win this hottie! She's a hottie!
We introduced this hottie! On this seat, you can watch the hottie fidget and sit around all day.
Alrighty then, first two questions. What is your favorite RTP sound effect? Gameplay, graphics, or story? Or are religious undertones important to you? We'll do religious undertones.
They can be lovely if handled properly. For me, that means not taking things too seriously. Not the vital aspect, of course. Well, now...
Oh, it crashed.
Oh, no.
Boom. None of that, I guess.
Oh, maybe. They don't want you to play a female's bride. We must prove the internet gods wrong, game gods.
Let's see.
We shall. Clicking. Relationship maintenance network. Make my score.
New game. New character.
Are you excited?
I am horny.
And there, horny.
Well, hottie crashed it, so we'll have horny.
You're horny?
Yes, I am. I am horny.
Therefore, oh my god, it must be really difficult to be horny all year round.
Yeah, eventually it gets kind of old. Do-do-do-do-do. Horny!
You just need a horn on your forehead. And you're good to go. And you're prepared for every life situation. Alright.
First three questions. Are religious undertones okay? What is the last game you played? Gameplay, graphics, or story? We'll go with two, just in case that quite religious question crashes it again. What do you think?
Ah! Last game I played was League of Legends, and I love feeding. And feeding refers to dying needlessly and getting the enemy team gold.
Okay.
Made, don't ask, played Barbarians in the Necromancer's Tower. It needed a lot more tower. What are you saying? Barbarians aren't enough. I'm offended. Made the drop. Yes, I think it was a tactical RPG, anyway. Yes, I still tool around in it from time to time to see how far I can get without dying. Answer: usually about 4 floors here, or that dungeon wall or thing, more like a wall like. Played the Grim Fandango Remastered Edition. I'm enjoying it mainly for the developer commentary. Any game designer should listen to those guys talk.
Okay, that I definitely like. What do you think, Horny? We
Interesting.
Think Grim Fandango. Because Grim Fandango. Roll up the next batch of questions. Here they are. RIPs, RTPs. How often do you game make? And where do you come from? Where do you go? How often do you game make?
And every other day. Ta-da!
Quick and easy?
Not nearly enough. I've been working the same game for 7 years.
Wow.
It's a 9-5 job for me, plus weekends. Yes, we are going with the diligent kind.
Yep. Gameplay, graphics, story, or sound? What do you always want to implement and or create? What's your favorite sound effect? Implement.
A real-time input-based battle system similar to those Mario and Luigi games. Yes. Come on. Touch my scepter. I've stopped jammering about it since I don't want to peer too far into the future, but my own video game company is still on the radar. I say company, but all my stuff will be free. I just mean paid artists, composers, etc. Not bad, not bad. I want to do a strategy RPG, or even just a regular RPG, where you start with one hero and eventually gain enough followers that you're controlling 100 at once. Oh, that reminds me of a game where you had to pick up people and you had just one huge line of people behind you and you needed to navigate the map with them all inside and you could block yourself. That was all part of the game. I've even thought about ways to shortcut certain commands and make it decently playable.
Yeah, we'll go with three. I like the complexity going on there. RIPs, RTPs, or custom? What is your idea of a wonderful game make session? What do you look for in a husband and waifu? Alright, we'll do the first one. What the heck?
I'm tied with anything as long as it looks good. Capiche?
Alright.
Customize RIPs, substituting RTP where necessary. That's how I roll. Seriously, that's what my current game uses. Yeah, I actually wanted to play that game, but it has so many reviews already. Butcher the RPG until it's unrecognizable, then make the rest yourself. Man up!
I'm gonna say two.
Yes. You're going for the rest.
I got you into game making. What's your best game-centric pickup line?
Yes!
Gameplay, graphics, story, or sound? Alright, we're going two. And that's the last question of the night. Booyah.
Hey, baby, how about I be the plumber to your war pipe?
Oh, God.
That's so bad. You're an artist, spider, writer, whatever. Can you give me some advice? Then, over the course of casual conversation, my natural charm swoons them. In theory.
That's not a pickup line.
That's not a pickup line. Can you give me some advice? And then you can leave. You must be a dual shock controller because I just want to give you the XR, 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 XR.
Oh, man. All right, the first one was just terrible, so I gotta pick that one. And the winner is Paramore 3! Come out and show yourself. It's probably gonna be one that I've already picked before. Whoa.
I don't... Oh, Diltree.
Diltree gets horny.
Oh, yes. Isn't that nice that one female character gets an animal mask? Isn't it?
Oh, yeah. When the chick comes out, the furries come out. Or dragons, or whatever that is. I can't really.
Oh, think. Too bad. Really.
It's like a dragon with a hat.
You know, these days, you know, if I hadn't made stuff before, I probably would have gone with the dragon because people would recognize me that way. 63.
Not bad.
Well,
not bad.
Decent.
And so we tried. Did not actually see you, didn't see you pop up at all. Kind of surprised.
Well, there are many people. If you go for the, you choose people, you can actually see. I think there were like, okay, I won't guess something that was a year ago, and I don't know how many there were. But it's at least 30 or something more.
No, yeah. They give you like a whole alphabet thing.
Yeah, yeah. And I can't see your screen, but that doesn't matter. Because, yes, under K, there are four matches. You may see me. Kicking ass.
You want to be Kalila?
You'll have to read all the text, or I can't see anything.
I just want to see your character. Which looks like your plate armor, sort of, kind of.
Yeah, just we call it the hair of a random Matty Beast sprite because I was too lazy to do anything that would fit in.
Oh, so cruel.
Yeah, and between the long...